Showtime guys, what's up? Max Ninja coming back to Laughing Loud with another Never mind, so I'm bringing you guys top 13. And why top 13? 13 is my lucky number. So, top 13 Super Nintendo games. My personal favorite 13 because basically this is opinion based. So that number 13, Bubsy.
What are you, stupid?
Nah, I'm just kidding with you guys. That one was a joke. But nah, for real. The real number 13. The Super Game Boy. You're probably saying, but Ninja, that's not a part of game. That's an accessory. But yes, this is true. But personally, you have the accessory, you have your Game Boy collection, boom! All your Game Boy games just became Super Nintendo games. I mean honestly, this item here is one of the best key items you have for any Nintendo collector. I would highly recommend this. So with that said, number... the original Killer Instinct. Personally, killer combos, killer everything. I mean, this game is fun inside it. I mean, I do happen to have a fun time playing this game. I mean, there's one more fighting game on this countdown, but I know I'm probably going to get a lot of hate after this next one. But yeah, Killer Instinct, I think, is a better fighting game all around. Faster pace, faster everything, and a good fighting game. Doom. Now this is actually nostalgia for me right here. This here was my first time ever playing Doom. Not on PC, but on the SNES. I mean, I remember being a little kid, running around, feeling like a badass, holding the BFG, and you're like, yeah! And you wait, take on the war. I mean, that was a fantastic film. I'm being honest, this game here, probably the reason why I stink at first person shooters is because I used to be the guy who runs in and just take everybody out. I digress. The Mortal Kombat trilogy. Technically, this one is the ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, the ultimate fighting game. And side note, that this one is actually one of the honestly, in my opinion, I think Killer Instinct and Mortal Kombat is a fantastic fighting franchise. I really enjoy both of these. And personally, honorable mentions, Mortal Kombat 1 and 2. Granted, the blood is kind of censored out of this one. So, just say the Genesis kind of has the Mortal Kombat on the first one. But I digress, the Mortal Kombat series, you can't go wrong with, it's a fantastic fighting game. Super Ghouls and Ghosts. Now this game, unlike its NES counterpart, Ghosts and Goblins, Super Ghouls and Ghosts is a beast of a game, just like its NES counterpart. I mean, honestly, if you play this game, one very simple rule. Get the knife. Because god dang it, you need the fast weapon to be able to even survive this game. Even on the NES, it was essential, you needed the knife. So, more or less, it's a tough game, it's fun. If you really want a challenge, I highly recommend it. But it's a little easier than Ghosts and Goblins, no. Now this one's actually straight up nostalgia. I remember being 5 playing this game, it's just possibly a nostalgia for me. Joe and Mac playing 2 cavemen, trying to save the cave babes. It's a fun little game. Not much to say about it, but the Joe and Mac. Mega Man X. Oh, what can I say about the Mega Man X series? That's Mega Man to the extreme EX. I mean, you play an X. I mean, honestly, you guys know what Mega Man X is. It's a fantastic Sideshow shooter. It's a great series. Highly recommend. I can't wait till the remix come out on Xbox, PlayStation. For Metroid, Super Metroid, a fantastic game. I mean, honestly, you play as the Bounty Hunter, Samus. You're trying. That's the third one in the series. It's a great game. Yeah, not much to say about that. Castlevania 4. Technically, it's a remake to Castlevania 1. It's a fantastic game. I mean, honestly, this game, now child, freaked me the hell out. I mean, honestly, it scared the butt out of me when I was a kid. But this game here, it's a great game. Anyway, so more or less, that's another honest. Why is it a great game? I don't know, just the emotions and everything else. Now I'm going to hear some people complaining about this one. Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past. Legend of Zelda, fantastic game. Any Zelda's are really good games. I mean, honestly, this one, the standalone only Zelda game that was released for the SNES. And honestly, this game is, well, pretty good. It's a classic. I mean, people still are debating which one was better, this one or Ocarina of Time. You know, hashtag, leave your comments down below. Which one do you think is better, Ocarina or Link to the Past? So, number 3. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3, 4. Turtles in Time. I mean, honestly, this one is dip. Again, nostalgia. Fun series, fun game. And honestly, it's a good size or beat 'em up. Fantastic for any NES collection. Donkey Kong Country. Side note, Donkey Kong Country. But here's a little side note. My opinion, I want to say the Donkey Kong Country trilogy should actually be the second place. My opinion, first one's good, second one was okay, third was one, was a little iffy. But I gotta say, this one is personally more my favorite one out of the trilogy. So with that said, my number one choice, drum roll please. Super Mario World and All-Stars. Because honestly, Super Mario World is a fantastic game. First time riding Yoshi, running around. I mean, this game is straight up a joy to play. I mean, personal note, this was actually the first time I had ever beat Bowser. And Mario All-Star Collection. Remastered 16-bit versions of the original Mario Trilogy. Highly recommend both of these games are great for any collection. So with that said, alright guys, so that was my top 13 list of Mario NES games. So if you'd like me to go into any detail of any of these games, please let me know down in the comments below, because I would love to go actually in for review on these guys if you want to see it. If not, hey, awesome. If you like it, give me a like. If you don't like this video, give me a dislike. Tell me what you didn't like about it. So, and if you want to see more top 13 lists like this, let me know. This is the Masked Ninja, sign off until next time.